Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I would like to say thank you for coming to my virtual presentation, and I'm glad to see you all. Let me introduce myself first. My name is Fahni Ashari, and I'm a medical student of Bengkulu University. In this time, I would like to present my article research, and the title is Effect of High Doses of Vitamin D Supplementation on Dengue Virus Replication, Toll-like receptor expression, and cytokine profiles on dendritic cells. First, we should know what is dengue. Dengue, caused by dengue virus infection, as you can see in my screen, the picture of the virus, and dengue is a public health problem worldwide. As we know that vitamin D can promote the innate immune response against virus infection, but no studies have evaluated the effect of vitamin D on dengue virus infection, dendritic cells, and inflammatory response regulation. This is the background why I did the research. Okay, let's move on to the aim. So, what is the aim? This study is aimed to assess the impact of oral vitamin D supplementation on the DENV2 infection, Toll-like receptor expression, and both pro- and anti-inflammatory cytokine production in monocyte-derived DCAs. This is the method of my research. To accomplish this study, 20 healthy donors were randomly divided into two groups and received either 1,000 or 4,000 international units per day of vitamin D for 10 days. And during pre- and post-vitamin D supplementation, peripheral blood samples were taken to obtain MDDCEs, which were challenged with DNV2. This is the result of the study. I found that MDDCS from donors who received 4,000 international units per day of vitamin D were less susceptible to DENV2 infection than MDDCS from donors who received 1,000 international units per day of vitamin D. And moreover, as you can read in my screen, the cells also showed decreased mRNA expression of TLR3, 7, and 9, and also downregulation of IL-12 per IL-8 production, and increased IL-10 secretion in response to DENV2 infection. Overall, we can get the conclusion that the administration of 4,000 international units per day of vitamin D decreases DENV2 infection. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the end of my presentation. Thank you so much for attending my presentation, and I'm sorry if I had mistake. And I close. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.